Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here today. And the topic of my presentation is multifunctional hedges. And so I would like to talk about the functions and the benefits of hedges for the climate, for production, for the farmer, and for biodiversity. For the climate, on the one hand, for reducing erosion and for the adaptation to climate change because of the improving of the microclimate, the production function, and increased regional added value for the farmer and for the region, and biodiversity. On this photo, you can see a hedge that has been planted in the south of Vienna in a very open and cleared agricultural landscape. And you can see the effect, the climate effect, and also the production, the beginning of the production effect of this hedge. The millet sown in this field has germinated much earlier when it is in this region where it was protected by the hedge than in the rest of the field on this side. And if we take a closer look on the plants, we see that the plants that are in the vicinity of the hedge are much larger than those growing about 80 meters or more away from the hedge. And at this moment, this photo was taken, it was time for the farmer to start mechanical weed control by harrowing. And those plants, those larger plants, they have no problem. They will withstand the harrowing without problems. While those small plants, those small millet plants, will be damaged. So without the hedge or away from the hedge, the farmer has to decide if he does the mechanical weed control now and damage the millet, or if he does not and has a weed problem afterwards. And this positive effect on the plants continued to the harvest. And in this area protected by the hedge, about 20 meters to 75 meters from this hedge, the yield, the millet yield was clearly higher than in the vicinity of the hedge and then without the hedge. And several years later, we conducted a similar analysis on the near the hedge that we will visit today in the afternoon, and we see the a similar picture of a spelt yield in this case. And this effect of the hedge, that it will it improves the microclimate, becomes always more important with increasing climate change, when it gets hotter and the climate gets more unpredictable. So this is an effect the hedge brings also for the future. It helps, will help us in the future. But now I'm going to concentrate on the effects of multifunctional hedges. The point with the multifunctional hedges is that they are planted in a way with plants that that bring an effect, a use for the farmer and for the farm. So this may be wild fruit and nuts in a case when the farmer has a direct marketing. So for example, greengage, morello cherries or cornel cherries that can be sold on the market, or they can be processed to regional products and marketed as a regional treat. The same is true, and there are many other berries, wild berries, that can be used in this way. Another possibility is to make use of the warm microclimate near the edge for Mediterranean herbs, for vegetables, or for exotic fruits, maybe. Or the multifunctional hedge can be planted in a way that is designed for using the wood, either for energy purposes or as fine woods for carving or other possibilities. We have in our brochure, I left it on my place, we have a brochure, Mehrnutzungshecken, and in this brochure we have collected a lot of examples what is possible. Wilfried said there are about 100 different multifunctional hedges, types of multifunctional hedges so far, and there is no limit to the ideas. The point is that the hedge is designed in a way that fits to the farm and fits to the farmer, and it brings a special service for the farm, a special additional benefit for the farm. And another point I want to stress is the agro-ecological services of multifunctional hedges. At the moment, we are monitoring the agro-ecological effects of multifunctional hedges. We are monitoring indicator species, indicator insects, wild bees, butterflies, and ground beetles, which are very sensible indicators. And I will just show you now a few examples of insects that the colleagues found near the hedge, in the hedge. Maybe several of you will know the red-tailed bumblebee. Bumblebees also belong to the wild bees, and they are valuable pollinators because they fly very early in the season when it's still cold. They fly from 2 or 4 degrees Celsius onwards when it's far too cold for honeybees, and start pollination. These sweat bees you will maybe see in the afternoon. In all cases, you will see those holes in the ground, the entrances to their nests. Sweat bees need those open soils with very sparse vegetation for nesting, and they are also valuable pollinators. They make real colonies, so several females overwinter together in their nests. With the butterflies, we have species that are rather common, that are maybe not so typical for the hedge, as the European peacock. The European peacock, the adult butterflies, don't have very special needs. They feed on many plants. They feed, for example, on dandelion, lymzan, but they also feed on the blackthorn in the hedge, the schlehen. But they are caterpillars. They have very special needs. They need stinging nettle, nothing else. But we also have butterflies. We have found butterflies that are more typical for hedges. This brown hair streak needs, on the one hand, woody structures, but also the open landscape. So this is a species that loves hedges and needs them. The brown hairstreak also feeds on blackthorn and on plums, so it will love this hedge. And if the agricultural landscape, the meadows near hedges, are cultivated too intensively, fertilized and cut very often, the caterpillars of these brown hairstreaks lose their habitats. So the brown hairstreak disappears in this case. So it is important that the area adjacent to the hedge also belongs to the hedge and is cultivated in an extensive way, which we will see today in the afternoon as well. And the same is true for the wood white butterfly. It also needs this hedges, woody structures, plus open landscape beside. And in addition, the wood white butterfly lays its eggs and has its caterpillars feeding on the outward leaves and outward twigs of the hedges. So if hedges, for example, near the street, cut Schönbrunn style, the eggs and the larvae of this butterfly also is cut away, and the wood white butterfly disappears. Yeah, and this is another point I'd like to stress, that windbreaks are not only a structure, a point in the landscape, but they link biotopes and they enable species to migrate and to recolonize areas where they were lost before. So, thank you for your attention.